Good evening. My name is Amelia, and I am a 14-year-old who goes to Shorewood High School. Tonight, I have a really fun program prepared, and I will be taking you on a little trip. Well, through time, because it's not like we can go anywhere right now. We start in the Baroque era, around 1720. I'll be playing Johann Sebastian Bach's second cello suite, of which he wrote six of. When writing these suites, it turned out he really liked the number six, so each of these suites consists of four movements as well. It starts with a prelude, or introduction, and then moves on to several different types of dance movements, such as a saraband or gigue. I don't know if you can tell, but I am using a Baroque bow, so that means the tip is a little bit longer and the hairs are a little bit, aren't as flat as a modern bow, and it's harder to sustain. And since the instruments have really changed over the last 300 years, I wanted to make my performance as authentic as possible. So here is Bach's second cello suite. Thank you. Okay, so next we're going to go to the classical era around 1770. I'll be playing a sonata by Boccherini. Similar to Bach, Boccherini published 6 sonatas, though he wrote almost 40. This sonata consists of 3 movements. However, there's so much confusion related to the manuscripts of this piece that most cellists only play the first 2 movements. In fact, there was once a manuscript that was published that had an entirely different second movement. The first movement is very lyrical and flowing, whereas the second is quick, lighthearted, and uplifting. Though it was originally written for 2 cellos, I'll be playing it with piano instead.
Thank you.
Okay, so next we're gonna move on to a little bit later, to the Romantic era in 1880, so something very different. Tchaikovsky wrote Pezzo Capriccioso over the summer of 1887 while he was visiting his friend who was sick and dying. The term caprice usually means something that changes moods or behavior rather quickly and is usually used in a lighthearted or playful way. However, the events that occurred over the summer took a toll on Tchaikovsky's morale, and he used the term caprice to represent something more melancholic. In fact, in a letter he called this piece the single fruit of my spirit from the whole summer. This piece is truly beautiful, and I hope you enjoy it as much as I do.
Thank you.
And the last piece that I'll be playing today is a 20th century work written around 1950. I'll be playing Ligeti's Sonata for Solo Cello. And this sonata consists of only two movements which were composed separately. The first, titled Dialogo, was written for an unrequited love. The notes in the lower register are meant to represent the voice of the man, and the higher notes and the higher register represents the voice of the female, therefore creating a dialogue. The second movement, Capriccio, is a very fast, aggressive, and almost abrasive movement. It's a very difficult piece, but it is so much fun to play. Before we end, I would like to first thank everyone, especially the United Methodist Church of Whitefish Bay for letting me perform here. I would also like to thank Joe, my pianist, for playing with me and rehearsing. I'd also like to thank Mr. Contreras, my teacher, for working with me, and yeah, he's been very helpful. And lastly, I'd like to thank everyone who's watching me back at home. So please enjoy Ligeti's Solo Cello Sonata.
Thank you.